Good morning, people. I've been a little bit dodgy on this old comeback onto the tubes of mine. Why am I so out of focus? Christ. There we go. So, today we've got full day of eating plus blood work breakdown. So, full day of eating on a rest day. And this is the last day of my deload as well. So, that'll be really nice. And obviously, we can get back into training properly and also probably videos as well. So, full day of eating, rest day. And also a little blood work breakdown at the end of the video. So, woke up around 8:30 today, because today's been our first day off in 2 weeks. I might be working like multiple jobs, which I'll also kind of touch on soon a bit as well. So today's been my first day off, so first day I can actually probably film as well. And also just let me means I could sleep in and catch up on the sleep where last night I fell on the sofa for like 2 hours, and then I woke up, had a meal, and then went back to bed and had like another 8 hours sleep. So I'm feeling super refreshed. Gorgeous day as well, so can't complain. So time is currently 9:15, meal one going down. So let's go get it.
Good morning. Hey.
Okay, so last part of the breakfast, so it was 2 bagels. Sort my shitty hair out, which I'm getting cut on Thursday for first rave of the year. So 2 bagels, 1 scoop of whey, squares bar, and that's meal one. So I'm gonna pop the macros for meal one here. So yeah, shit's getting pretty serious because I'm now doing 4,000 calories on a rest day. So that's pretty fucking hefty. So yeah, training day is like 4.5. So yeah, food is being pushed down, but it's tough. But we haven't got much longer left. If I do some speedy calculations, I will have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So yeah, I got 7 weeks left of this, and then I'm done ski. Maybe even 6, it depends how I feel. I might just do the 6 weeks then cut off there, because I'm literally dying eating so much food. But I've got some more pounds to put on, and then we can start the cut. So yeah, that's the plan. Gonna sink this, eat this, and then we'll move on to the next thing. Okay, so that was obviously meal one done. Now about to crack on with the morning work block, because we've got an online team to check in with. So team has been growing rapidly actually since the last couple of videos. We are up to around 12. So team's at 12, and I'm very, very happy with obviously how things are moving with everyone. Everyone's ticking along, everyone's taking a step closer every single day to their goals. Variety of goals, from bulking, cutting, and then like future bodybuilding goals as well. So a variety of different people, and obviously it's nice because obviously it means you kind of get to work with the bodybuilders, the people who love to bodybuild but don't want to compete. Then you got the people who are literally just interested in looking better, feeling better, and all the health benefits. So it's good, makes me a well-rounded coach is what I like it. So yeah, gonna do check-ins now and do some Trinity work as well. So we'll do a little time lapse. So sit back.
Do you notice the distance between us growing? Can you feel it? The change in the atmosphere. There's a gravity every time you're calling me. And even though we're worlds apart, I know that I can't stop. There's a gravity every time you're calling me. There's a gravity.
so that's meal two done. I also have a small glass of orange juice, 150 mils, which I've included with meal one. So that's why obviously like the macros were a little bit higher than obviously probably be expected in meal one. So I usually have that, and then I have my morning supplements, which I'm going to refill now as I refill them on Sundays. So I'll take you guys through what I put into my daily supplements, some rationale behind everything that I've been selecting, and to give some obviously insight into the reality of like the amount of health protocols you have to like cover when bodybuilding, but specifically assisted bodybuilding. So we'll take you guys now to fill up the pill pot, because I find it's the easiest way for me to remember to not forget to take them. Hope you guys can learn something from this. Macros for meal two. Here, also had another glass of orange juice as well. So that's meal two there. Okay, so we have got all the supplements out, ready to go. Got my pill case, just got us an Amazon. No particular special like modification or special brand. Literally just got an Amazon for like £6 or something like that. So, let's start with this one. So, Support Max from Strom. So this is essential for anyone who is on a anabolic cycle, anything where they're pushing their bodies out of normal ranges with blood work especially. So this is an essential. This is loaded with vitamin D3, magnesium, selenium, and acetyl and cysteine, I think I said that right. Citrus bergamot, betaine, tudka, CQ10, hawthornberry, dandelion root extract. So this covers everything in the general vicinity when it comes to liver, immune support, blood pressure, heart, everything you can kind of think of all in one. It's a really, really good product. So I take four of these a day. However, you are supposed to split it into two servings. So you take one serving in the morning, and then you take one serving in the evening, or it's just a spread out through the day, but I take supplements morning and evening. So this is for my morning. So I take two capsules in the morning, and then I take my two caps at night. If you wanted to, I'm sure if you could do like one with every meal, if that's to kind of like work better for you. But for me personally, this is what works best for me. I usually will take my vitamins after, well, sorry, my vitamins, my supplements after meal one, and then I'm good to go for the day. So Support Max sorted. Next up, we've got a probiotic. So this is for your gut health. This obviously is just really essential for keeping a healthy gut. This is what I recommend you take after you've had a course of antibiotics. So these will help with like when you take antibiotics, basically kind of breaks down your gut. So this will help put in good bacteria into your gut and that kind of good stuff. So I take one of these bad boys every single day. This is an essential. This is more of a bonus thing, which I have access to. So I usually will just take it. As why not? Why not take something if you have it? Next, we have got apple cider vinegar in the form of a tablet. Obviously, probably not as good as taking it, obviously, in its liquid form. However, this will obviously still be better than nothing. So this has got apple cider vinegar in it. It's got green tea leaf, cayenne pepper, ginger root, turmeric root, organic black pepper. So yeah, I take two of these a day, and this will help with, according to this, contributes to macronutrient metabolism and the maintenance of normal blood sugar levels. So really good for obviously keeping those blood, obviously fasting blood glucose level down, and obviously helping it as well with digestion, guts, all that kind of good stuff as well. So again, two of these every single day, just to obviously keep the levels good. In this one, it says take 1 to 3 every single day. So I take two every single day. So usually I'll take somewhere in the middle. Just because I think with the ones which are like this, which are like more extras than they are essentials, obviously rather save the money for the stuff where it needs to be spent versus obviously spending money where I don't need to. So yeah, so that is apple cider vinegar. Next we have a immune defense in the form of acai. So this is got, it's got zinc, vitamin B6, biotin, acai berry, beetroot, pomegranate seed, organic moringa, Oflera, I think they say it, grapeseed, and resveratrol, whatever the hell that is. So this will help obviously with obviously immune support, but it helps with obviously B6, which also reduces tiredness and fatigue, and zinc, obviously, which helps for normal bones, hair, skin, and nails. So again, this one is a take 1, 2, 3, as obviously every day. So I take 2 in the middle because it's a bonus. So I make sure I cover my base without having to go over the top. No, probably not. Drop one of these bad boys on the floor. So we'll spread these out 2 at a time. Shit, 3 and 1. 1, 2, perfect. Now moving on to liver clear. Liver markers, when you're an assisted bodybuilder, something you've got to look after very, very well. So I take extra stuff, obviously, when it comes to do with liver. Anything you need to do with liver, heart, and brain, and like cardiovascular, so including lungs, always load that up extra on. So here we go, liver clear. So this helps with normal function for liver, lipids, and metabolism, and also helps with macronutrient metabolism and energy yielding. So again, this one is a 1 to 3 every single day, so I take 2. So I know it's probably getting like pretty repetitive, but obviously this is just like kind of like me trying to like fill the gap of the space. You don't have to listen to absolute dead silence on this lovely rest day. Cool, liver done. Next, omega-3s for cholesterol. So I take 4 caps a day. Take 2 in the morning, 2 in the evening. So I'll put in 2 now, and then I'll obviously have 2 later. Again, omegas are really, really, really essential for your cholesterol, and also very, very essential for joint and brain. So obviously, you never take too many of these. Always, if you have ever listened to the podcast with Ian Bayer, he stresses how he will literally overtake his dosages on these, because there's not really like a limit to it in terms of like the more you take, the more benefits you will see. There's not really a cutoff period, or like it's just a case of take more, get more effects. Then we have a krill oil, another obviously like what would be the word, like it's like a partner with omega-3s, so you want to make sure you take in krill oil with your omega-3s. This will help with brain, and also helps with cholesterol as well. So this is what this one again. Yeah, so this is 2 a day. So that's what I'll do, 2 a day. As you can see, we are taking quite a lot. That's because health is very important. And we will get on to my blood work later, and you'll see how it reflects in my blood work. Before was I only introduced the omegas, like the extra, like heavier dosing of omega-3s, and the support max neuro shortly before I did my blood work. So my blood work will still continue to get better. But you can see already like the difference is made in everything that I'm doing. So we'll pop these bad boys in, and then we'll move on to next. We have got more omega-3s. This, however, is plant-based omega-3s instead of being fish-based. And with this, I will only take 1 of these, just because I'm already loading up loads. So I thought it'd be good to kind of like diverse my intake. So I've got these from, as I said, fish-based versus having them from like fish, plant-based to the fish-based. So I'm starting to lose my melon here. So yeah, just 1 of these, just because again, we're loading up heavy on the old omegas, just because it is better for you to do that than to not. Next, we have got cherry and beetroot. But it sounds like I'm running low, so I'll have to go find another one in the cupboard. I am, but basically this contributes with vitamin B6 for, again, fatigue, tiredness, protein and glycogen metabolism, immune system, and also red blood cell function, so, and formation as well. So, these will help with pump, if you know your stuff with beetroot. This also helps with the pump. So I'll have to go and get an extra one of these out the cupboard, but we also take these. We'll do that after. Then we have sea soil and greens. So this is basically greens from the sea and soil, hence the name. And this will just help with obviously getting my green intake up in the off season when you're obviously trying to get more food in. Sometimes you have to sacrifice a little bit of space for some more macronutrients instead of micronutrients. So if you're gonna do that, make sure you're then loading up on these. That way, obviously, you're not sacrificing your health. So again, nothing will ever replace eating the food itself. However, you can take precautions to make sure you can adapt for that. And even in the prep, when I'm taking extra, in the prep, even when I'm in a diet phase, I'm still taking these, basically these health products, because rather more than less, because again, when you're dieting, it can be quite detrimental to your health, especially obviously if you're doing it from a, an assisted standpoint. So we are super careful when we're doing things. And two more left, multivitamins. So we basically take, obviously, we cover a whole spectrum when it comes to vitamins and minerals. So vitamin A, vitamin D, E, K, C, and then all the other basically minerals that we need. So I've already covered quite a few of them in here. However, we take a few more because rather be safe than sorry. I normally take a better quality version than these, but I ran out and this came for free in a supplement order. So I just use it so that way I can save myself a bit of money, because at the end of the day, it'll still do the job, especially just for a little bit of time. We don't need them for the whole period. Oh, why is it getting heavy? Right, last but not least, we have telmisartan. So telmisartan is a blood pressure medication. This is not something you can get from a supplement store or anything. You do have to acquire this, usually via some ways which are not conventional, if you know what I mean. So telmisartan, so blood pressure. I had naturally higher blood pressure as a natural. So for me, this is super important, because then since I've been assisted, I noticed my blood pressure then got like spiked up quite quickly. So I am taking these every single day, so I can take those health precautions, because again, blood pressure is the silent killer in bodybuilding. So I do not need to be having high blood pressure, especially this early on. So I take 40 milligrams. I don't know if it's micrograms or milligrams. I think it's milligrams. I take 40 milligrams every single day. These are 80 milligram tablets, so I split them into two. And then I will have half a tablet every day, 40 milligrams. And that has brought down my blood pressure back into good ranges again. So super important, and especially if you're assisted, a necessity. A lot of people will take this as a prophylactic, so they'll take it as like basically a precautionary measure. Because rather be safe than sorry. So yeah, take half a tablet of these every single day. And then that's kind of it really. So yeah, so that is basically my, that's my supplements I'm taking right now in terms of health related ones. Again, not all of these are necessary. However, a lot of them are. And if you're assisted, there's no such thing as not necessary. You should be taking any precautions you need to in order to sort that, because again, it's just not worth taking the risk with your health. So on that note, we'll get back to the video. I've got more work to do after this, so I'll probably see you guys for the next meal to save you guys sitting through a shit ton more stuff. So hope you've enjoyed, and see you next clip.
This one, ¿qué se puede hacer para proteger el medio ambiente? So
is that what do you want?
Unusual sense.
Can I record now? Right, apologies for no recording in between the clips, and absolutely no apologies for this disgrace. So, basically, to try and fight the ever battle of forever battle of keeping this lovely hairline of mine, which I know you all want, I've been using rosemary oil on recommendation. Ella's been putting rosemary oil in my hair and massaging it in and giving me a little bit of princess treatment, because I'm a great little princess. Anyway, so I've been doing that to reverse, hopefully, or at least hold on to this lovely hairline, as you know. So, she can't take me seriously. You gotta check on that bloody rice cake again. Okay. Christ. Anyway, macros for meal 3 from earlier here for the chicken and rice meal. And then macros for meal 4 are here. That is macros for meal 4. Don't make me show you on camera right now. I will put it in. Anyway, so yeah. those are the last two meals. Plan of action now is to probably shower in a bit to get rid of this lovely oil through the hair. And then I'll double shampoo, is that correct?
Correct,
double shampoo. And then I'll be all sweet and I'll maintain this lovely hairline.
Fingers crossed.
Yes. So yeah, that's planned. And then we'll do a little run through with blood work probably tomorrow. So we'll do that because we're running out of time this evening. So yeah, we'll do that tomorrow. But for now, we've got one more meal left to have and then it is bedtime. So we'll catch you guys for the next meal. Okay, so here we are with the last meal of the day. Oh, so we've got, well, I've realized actually never told you what meal 3 and 4 was. So meal 3 was 150 grams. I was going to make sure I put all the menus. What the fuck am I talking about? All the meals on the screen, so I don't have to check if I've put all them on. So yeah, anyway, meal 5 is here. Macros for that meal are here. So as you can see, for rest day, it's a pretty hefty amount of food. And then full macros and calories for the day are here now. So there is that. But yeah, it's definitely been a long day. It's almost midnight. And unfortunately, this is the reality of the most of the time I get my last meal in. So yeah, gonna eat this and then head to sleep. And we'll chat to you guys tomorrow about blood work. Right, everyone. Welcome to the blood work part of this video. So let's get right into it. So first of all, obviously this is blood work after, I believe, like 25 weeks of being on anabolics. Obviously started at 150 milligrams of testosterone and I've titrated my way up to 300 milligrams of testosterone and 150 milligrams of primobolan. So this is where blood work is at. Straight off the bat, obviously you see a couple of reds here and there. These are actually not something to worry about. Oh, fuck off, customer care. You can get fucked, mate. See you later. So, we'll start off, we'll go through each individual one. So, red blood cells, everything was very much in the green, which is good because sometimes your hematocrit can get a little bit high when you're doing these sorts of things. In terms of anabolics, usually it involves at some point having to do some kind of bloodletting to reduce the amount of red blood cells in your body. Again, I'm still trying to get to grips with all like the reasons why, the terminology and whatnot. So I'm not an expert on this by any means, but I'm getting better. So yeah, anyway, red blood cells were all green. Then we have white blood cells. These were all also very much in the green. So these are also all good, so which is great. It means I'm not ill, which is good. So then we've got clotting status. Again, everything was smack bang in the middle. Kidney health. So it was just my creatinine. This is very normal when you train. If you train extremely hard, you will always have an elevated creatinine level. Even as a natural, you can very much be outside of the green on this. Just to give you guys some little more information, I can show you here. So look, high creatinine can be suggested that the kidney's not functioning properly, but they're also excreting the amount of creatinine. This also occurs, blah, blah, blah. For most people, this is to do with your EGFR, but this is also for individuals who are taking a creatine supplement, engaging in vigorous activity, this part being the key part. So I obviously know because my EGFR is fine, that it must be obviously because of my elevated levels from taking creatine and also from obviously vigorous activity. And again, it's at least just a smidge out of the mark. If I did, I took this blood test a day after two deload sessions, so they weren't full blown sessions. So if I took these after probably two rest days, this probably would have been obviously lower as well. Liver health was all sweet, which is obviously really, really good to see. Liver health being a really, really big marker, obviously we have to watch as we go along this journey. Proteins, so SHBG, this was down, so this is your sex hormone binding globulin, big word. So again, being on anabolics, this is the reason why it's lower, because I've got more free testosterone in my body. And then the albumin, I think that's how you pronounce it, this was just ever so slightly out the mark. So the reason why this might be high is usually to do dehydration, but also be to do with malnutrition, obviously, which is in the case inflammatory conditions, which potentially could be obviously to do with obviously being on anabolics because it does promote low key inflammation, and also just obviously because of dehydration potentially could be one because it was a test taken earlier in the day when I'm obviously not at peak hydration, so that's probably the reason why that is ever so slightly out. Apart from that, everything was all sweet. And again, the sex hormone binding globulin thing isn't a problem because we want, obviously, to have more free testosterone available. So then moving on to diabetes. So this was, again, smack bang in the middle. So they're obviously really, really healthy here. So no diabetes for me. My current, most recent, was it faster blood glucose levels? Christ, I'm really mixing things up. Was 5.1, so I'm still obviously very much in the green for that in terms of my insulin sensitivity and whatnot, so that's good. And then we have got cholesterol status. So I'm literally ever so slightly just out the smidge in all of my cholesterol levels. So again, this will be something that is going to be very apparent when being on anabolics. This is still better than it was in my previous blood work, which is good. I'm literally said, like, we can probably pull all these numbers back in range, but which I actually probably have already started to do because I've one been increasing, I've increased significantly my omega-3 content. I fucking hell does this, my omega-3 content has been significantly increased. And obviously on support max, which obviously will be super helpful from Strom, which obviously I kind of talked about earlier. And then cardio obviously is still at 3 times a week. And obviously going into a cutting phase, this obviously will help obviously alleviate some of the more cholesterol like numbers. So this should obviously be able to take that off. It might be a case of I might need to increase in off season to like a fourth cardio session in the week, which is perfectly okay. I can do that. But yeah, and that should be able to pull everything just back in line. But this is nothing to worry about as it can all be pulled back in line without too much intervention. Iron status, all good there. And then thyroid hormone, that was wrong. So my 3T3 was a little bit on the high end, if just to show you guys what this says. So high 3T3 can be an indication of an overactive thyroid. This happens when your thyroid gland produces too much thyroid hormone. Symptoms could be include sensitive to heat, losing weight, may have rapid heartbeat, I've got definitely a slightly higher, I was at my resting heart rate sits in the low 60s. Ideally, I like it to be in the 50s when I like my one of my peak prep is in the low 50s. But in off season, I like to keep it under 65 just because that's kind of like getting a little bit too high, especially some of my body weight and size. Another thing to kind of note on, so obviously, I'm having a higher T3 isn't a problem, especially if I'm obviously in a off-season setting, because basically that's going to do is just keep me a little bit leaner. So that's probably not an issue, because let's be real. Am I experiencing weight loss? Absolutely not. I'm going up. Fuck off. I'm going up, so that's obviously not a problem. I'm not taking any thyroid replacement hormones, so that's fine. So yeah, there's nothing really to be sketched about that, especially when I'm only smidge out the range again on this as well. But again, TSH was in range, which is good, and free thyroxine as well was obviously in range as well, which is good. Now, on to the part of the test that everyone is wanting to know about, and that is my hormones. So, without further ado, shaboying. This is not the number I wanted. Okay, so when I took my bloods at 150 megs of testosterone a week, I was at 50 nanomoles. So what does that mean? Why have I got 46.5 nanomoles? And that is just simply because the gear that I was using was watered down. Obviously, it was still working because it was pulling me out of natural ranges. So I was still obviously at 46 when edge of natural ranges to 30. So yeah, it still means I'm unnatty in terms of like levels. I'm still super physiological, so I'm still in a much more like higher testosterone state. However, it means my gear's watered down. So, and I don't know if that was the most recent vial I used. I don't know if that was the vial before that or the vial before that. You just don't know. And this is one of the reasons why it's important to get your blood test done, because you could get a batch
a batch vial, a batch lab, all those sort of things. So these things do happen, and it's just the reality of being an assisted bodybuilder, and that is you just don't know. Like, it's almost impossible to guarantee what you're taking is real. You just have to kind of like really hope that like the reference you've got, or the person who's recommended you, or this and that, is all being like legit. But my estradiol is lower than it was before, which shows that at least my primobolan is at least doing the job, which is to reduce my estradiol. So that's definitely still very much obviously real, even if it is Masteron, which is obviously kind of like the counterpart, which would do a similar effect. At least that is definitely working, because I believe my estradiol before was around 180 nanomol. Now it's down into 140, so it's a little bit more in the range, but still much, very much on the higher end. And yeah, so what have I done to adjust this? I have switched labs. So I'm no longer using the previous labs I was using, and I've now moved on to a new lab. Again, from a very reliable source, once again, definitely more reliable than my previous source was. So I'm hoping that's going to be sweet. But yeah, that's just going to, fingers crossed, and obviously hope for the best. Prolactin was all good. Free testosterone, obviously, again, kind of talked about earlier about the six hormone binding globulin. Testosterone, obviously, free left in the bloodstream is quite high, which is obviously to be expected. And then FSH and LH, these are to do with your production of testosterone, obviously, internally. Obviously, these are always going to be basically non-readable when you're taking exogenous hormones. So this is a very, very normal thing. So nothing to be alerted with that. That's very much normal. And this will not change as you stay on any kind of exogenous hormones. And then prostate, there was very much in the green. So that is also all good. So yeah, as you can see, like, the only thing to really note was testosterone was, it should have been higher, but not bad, but it should have been higher. Bad in terms of it should have been doubled, put it that way. I should have been around 100 nanomol plus, but it's not. So that is just the L there. But apart from that, all health markers are pretty good. Cholesterol should be pulled back in now that I've increased my my omega-3 intake and my krill oil intake, and obviously staying consistent with cardio. And then obviously proteins, obviously the 6 hormone binding globulin again normal, and the aluminum again kind of normal because I was a little bit dehydrated because it was earlier on in the day. It was like after like one meal, so that's probably why I probably could have done with probably getting like another 0.5 liter at least, and that would probably would have pulled that back in range. And apart from that, everything obviously all good. Say creatinine normal. So yeah, basically we're in really good top tier health. And what does that mean? So I was originally planning to do a health phase as I transitioned out of this gaining phase into my cut. and after like discussing with multiple people, I've decided that I'm not going to do the health phase just because all my health markers are in a good spot. So there's no point in me pulling off. The only reason I was going to pull off was if I'd been in a range where I was doing 100 plus nanomoles of testosterone for an extended period of time, versus like 45 nanomoles is something I can live with. Like, that's basically not going to cause any, like, not damage, but it's like, it's no reason for me to come off. So I'm going to stay on. And then we'll see, we'll assess further down the line, and see when my blood work is in need of basically being corrected, so coming off then. But for now, I'm going to stick to it, crack on. Hopefully, I'm going to retest my hormones just specifically. I'm going to retest those in 3 weeks now that I've switched labs. I did my first pin today with my new lab, and we'll retest it in 3 weeks' time and see where the levels come out. And they should again come out at double testosterone I was taking before. So that is all. If you guys have any questions or comments, leave them down below. Obviously, we'll answer all of them. If you guys want whatever you want to see next in the series of Grow to Pro, drop a comment down below. And yeah, I hope that answers all questions. And I hope you learned something, and I hope you enjoyed the full day of eating. So, on that note, like, share the fellow cunt, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.